Hey everyone, Justin here from Aquavit Woodworks, and welcome back to the YouTube channel. I apologize for not making a video in a long time, I've just been really busy with other custom orders. But today, I'm going to be showing you how I make these light-up snowmen. So if you want to see how I did it, stick around.
So to start this project, head out to your local big box store, buy a pine 1x12, and cut it to 24 inches. Then grab your favorite blue wood stain, a chamfer bit for your router, some aura mask to help with painting, LED string lights that I purchased on Amazon. These specific lights are linked down below in the description. As always, you'll need some sandpaper. I use up to 220 grit, a foam brush to help with staining, and then finally, you'll need a hot glue gun. After filming this and while editing, I realized that I didn't add the paint I used into this, so you will need some white, black, and orange paint as well. Once you have all your materials, it's time to start sanding. I sand up to 120 grit sandpaper before moving on to the router table to chamfer the edges. Okay, I'm at the router table with a chamfer bit in there. Now I'm going to chamfer over the edges. A few things about chamfering these. First of all, you want to make sure that the top side, the main part where the snowman is going to be, is the side where the cup is. So if you look at this board, it's hard to see. The cup is going like this. So this is the side that I want to chamfer. So this will be facing down. The reason I do that is because when I clamp it onto my CNC, I want the clamps to be on the sides to pull the cup down and keep everything flat. Another thing to know while chamfering is that you should start with the end grain. So chamfer both sides of the end grain and then do the other sides, and that'll help with any tear out. You could also add borders to this project instead of doing a chamfer like I'm doing, but that will add more material and more time. So let's not do that. Let's just chamfer these edges.
It's a quick process, and once you're done adding that chamfer, it's time to start sanding once again up to 220 grit sandpaper. I sand the top side that I finished on the router table, and then I sand the edges to make them nice and smooth.
Once everything is sanded, I can blow off all the dust and use a tack cloth to get all the dust off. And then I can get ready to start applying the stain. I do put my projects up on some painter's triangles because I don't stain the backs. That's totally my preference, but it's up to you. This is just Minwax blue stain from Lowe's. It is not the see-through kind, it is solid stain, so it's thick enough not to need to add pre-stain conditioner. And like I said, I only do the tops. I like to apply a lot of stain in the direction of the grain and then wipe it off with a paper towel.
All right, so everything is sanded, chamfered, and now stained. I did not stain the back edges, like I said earlier, and that's because I'm going to just sand them clean once it's dried, and just a waste of stain in my mind. Anyway, so I'm gonna let these dry overnight, and now I'm gonna head into Carbide Crate and start assembling my toolpaths for this project. So let's go hop onto the computer.
This is a really basic project in terms of toolpaths. You just use a V-carve for the text, a contour for that bottom snow line, some pocket toolpaths for the snowman, and some pocket toolpaths for the snowflake holes. It uses two different bits, a 90 degree V-bit and an 1/8 inch downcut bit. If you click on the link for the files in this video description, you will also get a PDF instruction manual on how to assign toolpaths. Once our file's all set, I headed back into the shop and started applying the aura mask to the top of my workpiece. I use the edge of an old 2x4 to make sure the aura mask is flat and smooth on the surface. Once the aura mask is applied, it's time to throw the piece onto the machine, clamp it down, set your zero, and start carving.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
All right, so our snowman is off the machine. That took about 20-ish minutes. I forgot to mention for materials in the beginning of the video, but you will need paint for this. I'm gonna use white paint, black paint, and orange paint for the nose here. So just peel off this bottom layer of ore mask so you can paint the snow on the bottom and start painting.
Because there's ore mask on this project, it's extremely easy to paint. Just paint the snowman white, his arms black, his little buttons and mouth black, the text white, and of course the nose orange. After everything dries, take a weeding tool and peel off the ore mask.
All right, so the paint is dry, and all we have to do now is add our lights with some hot glue that is now warming up. So if you flip these boards over and grab your lights, this battery pack is gonna be at the bottom. And one thing to note is that you should put the switch right at the bottom. I'm gonna glue this on later, I'll do that last. Before you start gluing these lights into place though, it's helpful to test insert them before applying the glue because they really only go in a certain amount of ways. These lights are about 4 inches apart, so you can't go out of order or else you'll miss one. So just do a test run lining them up before you put the glue on. I've already done that a few times and I made these in the past, so I know it's gonna work. But yeah, so start hot gluing and then we're almost done.
While gluing this up, I find it helpful to insert the light just partly into the hole, add some hot glue, and then shove everything down into the hole so the hot glue kind of gets stuck in there and holds it in place. Once the lights are in place, I just take some scrap wood and tack it to the back of the board so that it holds it off the wall and doesn't hit the battery pack while you hang it.
I know I said I wasn't going to add staples to the back. I changed my mind. I'm going to put these small staples to hold the wires down. So hammer those in. It'll just make it a little cleaner. I was wrong, I'll admit it. Here's some advice for you. Before you put these LED strips into the signs, test the lights. I didn't do that. So I'm not sure that if I hit a wire somewhere and broke it while hammering in these staples or what, but these lights don't turn on. And they're already glued into place, so I'm gonna have to rip them out, which is gonna be messy because it's all hot glued. So stay tuned, and with the power of fast forward, I will show you what the finished product looks like. Let's do this. Alright, well that was annoying and it's my own fault for rushing, but here is the final product. I think it looks pretty good. These were really good sellers for me last year. I'm going to make some more of them and I'm not going to rush through them so that I don't mess up the backs like I did on this one. You can hang these on the wall or just lay them on the ground against the wall. Some people do that in some kind of Christmas display. But either way, super simple project and they sell really well for me in New England. So hopefully you can have some luck with them too. Give me a like and a subscribe, and if you want the file, follow the links in the description to get the plans. Thanks for watching.